And there's good treatment for this as well, right?
Absolutely.
I remember seeing it as a child, the little needle that goes in, grabbing that vein, and shoo, it just all of a sudden disappears. It's really fascinating to see, I have to be honest. Is that what you do?
Yeah, we do that, and nowadays, there are a whole host of treatments available for varicose veins, all of which are very good and very simple, and many are office-based.
What about for the more severe cases? Because there can be some that are more severe.
Absolutely.
A little bit more difficult to treat.
It all depends on what I see when I evaluate a patient. If I see a patient who has, for example, painful varicose veins or leg swelling, perhaps they tell me that, hey, doc, my legs are just really tired and swollen at the end of the day, and I really want to put them up. That instantly tells me that there's a likelihood that some more significant superficial veins may be involved, and it may be a little bit deeper than just the veins that we see out on the surface. In those situations, we get a ultrasound for evaluation, a very special type of ultrasound, not the typical vein ultrasound that maybe most patients are familiar with, where we try to rule out deep vein clotting. This ultrasound involves a couple of maneuvers that really looks at functioning of the vein valves, and we call it a reflux ultrasound particularly. So that tells the treating physician where the problems are in the venous system and what veins can be treated, because very oftentimes the veins that we see out on the skin are caused by another vein a little bit deeper down, and the ultrasound often tells us where in that evaluation or where the treatment best lies.